Imagine this. You think you have woken up with your mind thinking about the upcoming day, but you cannot move at all. You can see a little, and the sun is out. You think you can move a little, like your fingers and toes, but not your whole body. Worst of all, you cannot speak. Basically, you are conscious, yet you cannot move. Almost like you are possessed or paralyzed. You think you might never be able to move forever. Then, all of a sudden, after a very, very deep breath, you wake up, regaining control of your body. And your body feels super tired and weak, but yet, you feel super, super relieved because you have regained the use of your body. Believe it or not, this is a common experience that maybe millions of people have experienced it this morning. Called sleep paralysis, up to 4 out of 10 people have experienced this before. Now, what the heck is sleep paralysis eh? So, as scary as it sounds, our voluntary muscles are always paralyzed when we are asleep. See, when we sleep, our brain tells our body's voluntary muscles to chill out and then go into a state of paralysis, which is called ananganyonyonga. This restricts our physical movements while we dream, which helps to protect the body from any external injury. In those with sleep disorder like sleepwalking, ananana does not occur properly, which is why their muscles can move. Their mind is asleep, but their body is awake. In sleep paralysis, the opposite happens. You are awake and conscious, but are unable to move voluntary muscles. While we don't know how many people actually have sleep paralysis, it's estimated that around 8% to 40% of people experience sleep paralysis at some point in their life. Men and women of any age can get it. Now, here's something you didn't know. Many people who experience sleep paralysis also have hints during their episodes. You see, in my intro, I thought I saw the sun, I thought I've moved a little, etc. They're actually all hallucinations. Like how AI always hallucinate fast up. Wait. Does that mean that AI are in a sleep paralysis and one day they might just wake up?
Oh, majestic potato in the moon
According to the Sleep Foundation, there are three types of hallucinations during sleep paralysis. First is chest pressure hallucinations, which incite a feeling of suffocation. Secondly, is vasomotor hallucinations, which can also include feelings of movement or out-of-body sensations, which I felt in the beginning of the video. Finally, is intruder hallucinations, which involve the perception of a dangerous person or presence in the room. As someone who have experienced sleep paralysis, I've often experienced the first two, but not the third before. So I tried asking my friends what type of hallucinations they have while experiencing sleep paralysis. But I don't have friends, so I don't know. Now, if you think about it, this is why in Chinese it's called piyasen, which is translated into ghost pressing on the body. Because in the past, people believed that when that happened, we're either being pinned down by a supernatural creature called the night hairy, or we are possessed. They have not seen how a person who's possessed acts. A person who's possessed is like a wife who scolded you when you buy the wrong things home.
Hey Bodo, I say buy pets with wings for NTUC ma.
Hey Bodo, pets with wings ma.
Hey Bodo, you know I only eat chicken wings from Wingstop, what you buy from KFC?
So, why do people have sleep paralysis eh? The cause is still unknown, but there are a few theories on why sleep paralysis occurs. It could be due to irregular sleeping patterns or not getting enough sleep. Genes can also contribute to it. In fact, personal experience is that if I drink too much coffee, I will have a higher chance of experiencing sleep paralysis. So long story cut short, there's no clear answer. The good news is that it's often relatively harmless and no clinical death have been linked to it. If you experience it again, just try wiggling your toes and see if it helps. If not, just tell yourself that it's sleep paralysis and wait until you wake up. Just remember this, you eventually wake up or just remember me when you're experiencing it. Which means I've become a dream cat. There are also theories on how to prevent it, but because I've tried them and they don't work, I won't be telling you about them. But all in all, it's just to have good sleep hygiene. Which is like a doctor tell you that you can be healthy just by exercising more and eating more fruits and vegetables. You don't know lah. Now, if you think I learned something, consider subscribing. And thank you for spending 4 minutes with me. I appreciate it.